Hi, good morning, everyone. My name is Wei Cui. I'm from Squirrel AI Learning, headquartered in Shanghai. Today, I'm very glad to be here to share what we did in the past 4.5 years and our opinion in the future education. So my topic is about the developing a super one-on-one tutor with AI and big data. So first, I would like to give you a sense of the education market in China. Because the reason is that most of you probably come from, I know you from all around the world, but most of you probably from the Europe and from the US, but and also the UK. But however, the Chinese education market is different from the other places in the world. Especially the education market, the Chinese education is very, very competitive in China, because there is such thing called the college entrance exam. Every family wants their kids, their son or daughter, to get to the quality universities or colleges, which means that they can get a better job in the future. So this picture shows that the top 5 education companies in China, and all of these companies are doing the after-school tutoring business. And this is the reason I just mentioned, because every family thinks that their education in the public school is not enough, so they are sending their kids to the after-school tutoring, the learning center, to pursue further education. However, we found that the top 5 education companies in China only represent less than 5% of the market. So which means that the education market in China is very segmented. Probably you can guess how many education companies in China. Or anyone can give it a try. Let me just tell you. There are about 500,000 education companies in China, according to the statistic of the Chinese government. This is just a rule. Actually, as our estimated, there are about 1 million education companies in China. So this means that the market is very segmented, and those top 5 education market only exist in the tier 1 and the tier 2 cities, which means that they could not go to further to the lower, to the tier 2, tier 3, tier 5, tier 6 cities. The reason is this: the number of the teachers could not matching the number of students, which means that the quality teachers are lacking in China. Are very much lacking in China. I think it's similar to some places in the world. So this leads to several issues of education issues in China. First is the learning efficiencies are pretty low. The high performance students, they want to learn more things. The low performance students could not catch up with their classmates in the classroom. And the second is the learning effective could not be guaranteed, because only less than 5% of the teachers are quality teachers. And most of the teachers are below the middle, the average, below the average. So they could not provide the high quality education to the students. And in our traditional classroom, the learning is very, very linear. So every student learns the same speed, learn the same content. And you know that every kid is different according to this professor, which is one of the most popular TED talk. Yeah, according to his talk, every kid is different, and every kid has tremendous talents. However, our current existing education could not provide such personalized education to every kid due to the shortage of quality teachers. So we are trying to solve this problem. We are trying to use the most advanced techniques to provide such personalized education to every kid in the world, to let every kid to have the quality education, to have the quality personalized education. That's what we want. So our system has 3 components. The first component is the ontology, which have the knowledge graph. We have the hierarchical knowledge graph. We also have the 9 levels of hierarchical graph. We also have the prerequisite knowledge graph. So the hierarchical knowledge graph and the prerequisite knowledge graph represent the knowledge experience of the expert teachers. And the prerequisite knowledge graph can have the connections between two knowledge components, which represent their prerequisite connections between them. And the second component is our interface. So in our interface, our system actually has two teachers. One teacher is the virtual teacher, and also we have the human teacher aside. So in our learning centers, there are two teachers give the personalized education to every kid. So in our system, we have the content repository. We have lots of the videos explaining every knowledge component, and we have different type of question, assessment question, and practice questions. And every student is our center. So we provide the student-centered education, not the traditional teacher-centered education. And our adaptive education is competence-based learning and also mastery-based learning. So there is one AI teacher and also there is a human teacher. So most of the time the students spend their learning through the virtual teacher starting the learning machine. And our AI teacher is just like a coaches. They help the students when the students need their help. And our learning centers provide the high-tech, relaxed environment to the student traditional classroom, because we want the students to relax, feel different from the traditional classroom, so the student can have good mood, can have good motivation to study in our learning centers. So what have we achieved so far? Currently, we have benefited. There are about 2 million students using our system, K-12 students use our system. Currently, we have created five subjects contents, including the mathematics, Chinese, English, physics, and chemistry. And there are nearly 2,400 learning centers across 600 different cities in China. And most of the learning centers covered in tier three, tier four, tier five cities, not the tier one, tier two, because the tier one, tier two cities, there are lots of quality teachers. And from 2018 and 2019, for the continuous 2 years, and we have received the award of the high-tech, high-growth companies awarded by the Deloitte. There are four main functions of the adaptive learning system. So we provide the initial diagnosis of the student's knowledge state. We diagnose the student's weaknesses. And then during the learning process, our system can continuously evaluate the student's knowledge state, the learning efficiencies on each knowledge component at real time, and so that we can have updated student profile. Based on the student's profile, we can do the personalized recommendation. There are two types of recommendation. The first, we recommend the most suitable learning content according to the student's performances. So we recommend the difficult one to the high performance students. We recommend the easier ones to the low performance students, so that we let every student can study at their comfort zone. Everyone knows that there is a GPD theory. And also we recommend the optimal learning path to students. So in our learning process, after we diagnose the student's knowledge state, we know their weaknesses. So during the learning state, every student only need to study their weaknesses. The knowledge component they have already mastered will be ignored. They don't need to study the master one. So for those weaknesses, we recommend the more optimal sequence for those students to learn. So every student will have a personalized learning path. So this X-ray, want to demonstrate how we diagnose the student's knowledge state. So we diagnose every knowledge component. And after the diagnosis, we find out the knowledge state of every student. This just shows three knowledge states for three different students. Even they have the same mastery rate, 80%. And these three students have totally different learning path because our system can recommend the optimal path for them at the real time. After students study one knowledge component, we recommend the next knowledge component to study based on his performance, his previous performances. So every student has the personalized learning path. And also every student has personalized learning content. So our algorithm can decide how many questions that student needs to study, how much time that student needs to spend on that knowledge component. So for different students, for different knowledge component, students will have personalized learning content. So the time spent on different knowledge components just like this. So, and the core part of our learning system is the engine. So due to the time limit, I just to talk about a few of them. So most important is the intelligent recommendation engine, and the second is the learning analytics engine. And we also have the virtual. The other three in progress research work. We also want to have the robot, the chat robot, and also we have the MIBAR system to capture the students' facial expression, the gestures, the eye tracing, and or even the brainwave data so that we can better understand the students' performance and knowledge state. So we still doing lots of the academic research. We have collaborated with CMU and SRI, and also published many academic papers. And one of the important output of the academic papers is the comparison work, comparison studies, empirical studies on the human and the machine competition. So we have two group students. One is taught by the machine, the other is taught by the human. So the result shows that our machine can outperform the human teachers for some subjects. And then I would like to talk about the future study. According to our previous experience, previously the students using our system, the AI-powered adaptive learning system. So one story is about that recently in this summer, so we went to a poor remote village in China. So the families are very, very poor, so you can according to their average salary. And so the students, there is a primary school. The students could not have quality teachers. For the past 4 years, the mathematics teacher has changed. There have changed 7 to 8 teachers, and there is one voluntary teacher still staying there. However, although he is a mathematics teacher, he needs to teach Chinese, English, and even sing to those students. So what do? We provide our adaptive learning system to them, let them to study for the summer, for the whole summer. So this shows that their knowledge state before they're using our system. We can see from that even the students are grade 6 students. However, their performance is pretty low. They're lower than the grade 4 students in the town, in the primary school in the town. So what do we do? What are we going to do? Our adaptive learning system will not provide the grade 6 knowledge from them to study. Our intelligent adaptation will trace back to the grade 4 knowledge. So their students will start study from the grade 4 knowledge component, and then grade 5, and then grade 6. So after 1 month study, their mastery rate has increased from 46 to 89%. In 1 month, just in 1 month. So this could not be done by their human teachers. This is just an example. Yeah, and also there is another case. This, and she is the daughter of our chairman's driver. So due to his driver, we know that he could not provide to know how to teach her daughter. So her daughter's English is very, very poor. Not even to say he will study in foreign countries abroad. However, after starting our system for 1 month, so he will use our system after school, so every day use our system to study without any intervention from the human teachers. So after 1 year, his performance has improved a lot. And finally, he went abroad in Seattle to study in Boeing, so which means that a bright future for her. And this is not just one case. About 80% of our students who will get improved in our system after using our system for one semester or for 1 year. So we believe that due to our past experience, we believe that in the future classroom, the AI teacher and the human teacher will work together. They will coexist in the future classroom. But their tasks are different. The AI teacher will be responsible for the content mastery, for the knowledge delivering, for the knowledge transferring, and the human teachers will be responsible for teaching the critical thinking, the problem solving, the collaboration, effective communication, self-directed learning, and academic mindset, which are lacking in our existing education, especially in China. And another story I want to share that in the TV show about the last half year of this year, so we did a TV show. What do? That we do a career prediction. So we let six people from different jobs And then we did a test. And our test will show, we predict what their actual job is. And this is the job. And we can accurately predict their career, what the career is, using our assessment. And another example, and this is the twin sign of our chairman. And they are grade two students. They have already started programming, and this is the output. They programmed the Chinese chess and also the international chess. And also they have make a bigger challenge. They have started grade eight physics. In China, we only started physics in grade six, but they have started the grade six physics for 1 year, and they started pretty well. So what we have achieved? Why we can do this? So because our system not only teaches the students the knowledge, we also teach the students the lifelong learning capacities. So we call them the MCM system, which stands for the methodology, the capacity, and the mode of thinking. We have break down those learning points, the learning components, and we use the knowledge component in the curriculum as the carrier of those MCM. So what we want to teach our students, not only the knowledge, but also the lifelong learning capacities. So that's the reason we can predict their career, use our system. So we also believe that in future education will be career oriented. So the students, the kids, tell us what their future job, what they want to be, so that our AI machine system can provide the corresponding learning material for that student. So that's the thing, and we can see the examples. Our system has benefited lots of students in China, and we want to benefit more students in China and also in the world. Do you know how many K-12 students in China? We just benefit a small amount, 2 million. There are 200 million students in China, K-12 students in China, so we hope to help more students in China. And we have created the Squirrel AI Open AI platform, so any learning management system can connect with our system. And we have donated 1 billion student study account. So we believe that the future education will be more and more equal. And we believe that the AI techniques, the advanced techniques, because the AI system can evolve in the future, can be better and better. So we believe that in the future, the AI can revolutionize the education. The college entry slam could be disappear, and the school district properties could disappear in future. And so my last word, we think that the future education will be more effective and more efficient, and every kid will have a better qualified, personalized education. That's my talk. Thank you very much.